Now I am going to start your today's lecture. Please take out your English books, your lead pencils, as well as your diaries in your hands. I'm repeating it again. Please take out your lead pencils, your English books, and your diaries in your hand. It's a very good. Okay, let's start today's lecture. Please take out the page number. Please take out the page number 39 from your books. Take out the page number 39 from your books. Okay, students, take out the page number 39 from your books. Today we will go to start reading the use of English. Before starting our today's lecture, let's start with our thought of day or a message of a day. So today's message or today's thought is, do what is right, not what is easy. As you can see that this quotation is written in the quotation marks. These marks and these two commas are known as a quotation marks. So this is reported. This is said by someone. When the something is said by someone, we use these commas, and these commas are known as reported marks. So what the writer want to say, we need to do right things in life, not easy one. We need to choose the right path in our life, not easy path. Now students, move towards today's lecture, and as you can see on the page number 39, on the page number 39, you all can see there is a question that is written as talk about our article with group, with your group. Which fact did you find the most surprising? What other sport have you seen people with disabilities do? So this is the question that you need to do and ask with your companion, with your friends, and with your fellows. Okay, so the first question is, talk about the article. Which fact do you find the most surprising? As you remember, in the previous class, that means in the previous week class, we discussed about a Paralympic athletic and a Paralympic athlete. And can anybody tell me what is the name of that Paralympic athlete whom we already learned about? Can you answer me in the chat box? Can you answer me in the chat box the name of the para athletic? Jessica, very good. The Hannah Cockcroft. So the name was Hannah Cockcroft. Humne uski story padhi. And now I'm going to ask you, what is the surprising thing that you feel in this article? You need to discuss with your partner. After reading it, what I feel that most surprising thing is that she is disabled person, but she tries to fight with her disabilities. Okay, and prove the word, yes, I can. So this is the most surprising thing, that she wants to prove and she wants to be an embodiment for all of us. Mashallah, we all are blessed with hands, feet, and every kind of a blessings. In spite of all these blessings, sometimes we feel a temperature, headache, or any kind of disease, and we feel that we are unable to perform our duties. So this lesson and this character of Hannah Cockcroft is only a message and only an embodiment for all of us, that if a human being wants to do something, they can. Okay? So this is the answer of the question. Guys, this is the question, answer of the question. As you can see that this is labeled at this is the question number 4 from the page number 39. Beta, be attentive when the teachers are delivering the lesson. Okay, the sports that person can do, that the disabled person can do. There are many sports that a disabled person can do. Some of them I am going to mentioning here. Cycling, as you can see the example of cycling and the picture of the cycling. Chess, as you can see that the person who is disabled sitting and playing the chess. And sitting volleyball, as you can see that the person, they all are sitting on the wheelchair and playing the volleyball. So this is the answer of the question that we have discussed today. One is the surprising fact and other the sport the disabled person can do. Student, if you want to write some other examples, you can also write. I have only written the example which I found. You can add it according to your taste and according to your knowledge. So this is the one question which we have done today. Now, just move toward the question, use of sentence. As you can see on the page number 39, there is a mention of the topic with the heading use of sentence. Before starting that topic, we need to know about what is reported speech. Because in that use of sentence, we will going to talk about the reported speech and direct statement. Okay, whenever we write a sentence or an interview, we feel that there are two types of statements are there. One is the direct statement and second one is the indirect statement. We can call the direct statement as an reporting speech, while the indirect statement is known as a reported speech. Got it? Okay. Reported speech. Direct speech or the reporting speech is something that is directly said by a person. As you can see that the person is playing the football, baseball, and the person is directly saying, "I play baseball with my friends." This is the direct statement said by a person. When the second person hears that statement, she hears that statement and the third person asks her what that person said. So the second person replied in an indirect form. And she said that she plays baseball with her friends. Hope so, it's clear to you all. Now, move toward the actual topic. Take out the page number 39. and you can see that the use of English, there are the two type of the sentence we are going to discuss today. One is the direct statement and second is the reported statement. As I already tell you, the direct statement is also known as reporting statement and the reported statement. We are only focusing here on what? We are only focusing here on present tense. Sorry, students. So we are only focusing here on the present tense. So we are only focusing here on the present tense, the reported speech of the present tense. Hope so it's now clear to you all. If we say something directly, so we use, what we use? I hate being told that I can't do things. So as we discuss in the start of the lesson, we use commas, the quotation mark, the commas. Okay, so the answer of that example is Hannah says that she hates being told that she cannot do things. So Hannah says that she hates to told that she can't do things. So this was the direct. जब हम इस direct को change करेंगे in the reported statement, तो ये पूरी quotation marks वाले कोमे को हम क्या करेंगे? खत्म कर देंगे. And then we use such a kind of a sentence. Hope so now it's clear to you all. The next is with WH question. WH question का मतलब है you need to ask with the question how, what, when, such a kind of question. How do you live with your disability? So the reported speech is she wants to know how she lives with her disabilities. So this is the answer. Now move towards the question number 6. Find other example of direct speech from the text. Question number 6, as you can see on your books, find other examples of direct speech from the text. Write them in reported statements. So these are the some examples that I choose from your book, from the abstract or from the extract of Hannah Cockcroft. Okay, we have written them. The black statement is written as a direct statement, while in the white color you can see the white color statement are the reported statement. So the direct statement was she asked her, how do you live with your disability day by day? So the what is the reported word? The reporter want to know that how she lives with her disabilities. Next one. Hannah said, I hate being told that I can't do things. Hannah replies that she hates being told that she can't do things. Third one, I can't run, but I can wheelchair race faster than people can run. So the reported statement is she says that she cannot run, but she can wheelchair race faster than people can run. Now move toward the fourth one. We ask her, you had a great success at the 2012 Paralympics. What are your plans for the future? So the reported statement for that sentence is, she asked her that she had a great success at the 2012 Paralympics. So what are her plans for future? And then fifth statement, I want to complete it in another 3 and 4 Paralympics. She says that she want to compete in another 3 or 4 Paralympics. Hope so, students, all the things are clear to you all. Now move towards the homework task. The very much asked question from you all, जो आप पिछले 5 मिनट से मुझसे पूछे, yes students, you need to do the question number 4 on your English A copies and you need to consult the page number 39 for it. You need to question number 6 on your English B copies and you need to consult the page number 39 for it. Hope so it's clear to you all. Please take out your diaries and note it down.